Welcome to Under the Lights. I'm Denise Thompson.
And I'm Gino Gradkowski. Thanks for joining us. It's good to get another win under our belt this past weekend. You know, I thought the offense got off to a fast start. It's always good to start the game with an opening drive that ends in a touchdown. There were opportunities for us to pull away a little bit in that first half that unfortunately we didn't take advantage of and allowed Dixie State to hang around, which is, you know, when you're playing a team that you know that you're better than, especially when you're at home, it's important to capitalize on those opportunities and pull away when you can. Allowing Dixie State to stay in the game made it a game throughout the whole all four quarters. But, you know, two turnovers inside the 20 hurt us and a missed field goal. You know, those opportunities that we could have scored points to pull away. But, you know, overall, I thought the offense moved the ball really well throughout the game. I think Zach is improving and it's showing on film. And then the defense played outstanding again, holding Dixie State to negative 4 yards rushing. And really, you know, when you give up only 10 points, you're setting yourself up to win the football game. So, you know, overall, it's good to get a win, good to put ourselves in a position where we can finish out this year and still give ourselves a chance to make the playoffs.
You know, and for the fans that did come out on Saturday, I mean, the weather was great, right? It was all the fixings that you needed for a Halloween weekend type game. And of course, to pick up a non-conference win at home is always good. You know, that victory, Gino, moved us to 7-1 at home at Delaware Stadium, dating back to November 16th, 2019. You know, you've been here that whole time. You know, for that 7-1 record, is there a game that you remember, you know, that kind of puts a smile to Blue Hens fans out there everywhere?
Yeah, I just think about the opening game last spring against Maine. You know, the team was waiting all year to finally get back on the field, not really sure if they were going to get an opportunity to play games last year. And they finally got that opportunity in the spring, came out swinging with a big win, big conference win against Maine last year, opening the game with a Dejon Lee kick return to the house. So that game sticks out to me, and that really set us up for the impressive run that we had last spring.
Yeah. You know, and this weekend we are home again, having William and Mary, you know, waiting for fans to come out. But, you know, another good thing is that it is military appreciation game, you know, as well as Hall of Fame. So a lot of things going on. If you're a current person serving in the military or if you're a veteran, you know, we do have discounted tickets available. You know, we have two games left, William and Mary, then another 2 weeks away. Then we have Villanova. So plenty going on here in Delaware Stadium to catch that hype, you know, that's been going on at home.
Yep, three big conference games to finish the year here for the Blue Hens. And then, you know, this it's great that we have two of them at home. The one on the road is against Richmond. Yeah. And this week, our defense is going to have their hands, their work cut out for them. They're playing William & Mary, who's the top three scoring offense in our conference, as well as the top offense, rushing offense in the conference. So, you know, I'm excited to see how our defense is going to play this week against William & Mary. I love that we're finishing the game, the season against three rival opponents from the conference. And, you know, I'd love to see a Blue Hens pull out a victory this weekend against William & Mary.
You know, absolutely great things going on. And another good thing going on is that we do have the Hall of Fame ceremony this Friday here at Delaware Stadium. And we have two football players that are being inducted, you know, of the greats all there. You know, just to be able to have two, I think is just like a cherry on top for what's going on. You know, we have John J. Jack Turner, as well as the late Lenny Williams, who are being inducted. And I'm not even going to try and memorize all of the great things they have going on, you know, but for Jack, you know, top player for UD in the 50s, an All-American, a native of Philly. And, you know, one thing for him is a 3-year starter at halfback and defensive back. That alone says a little bit way too much of what actually you could do back then. And, you know, in 1959, he did lead the Blue Hens to an 8-1 record. You know, when he finished his career, he had the career record for rushing touchdowns. He also had 5 career interceptions, you know, going on. I mean, so, and then he did return kickoffs and he did punts. So pretty much I'm saying he was a do-it-all kind of guy, an all-around player, probably way more energy than the guys today can even muster up. So definitely be happy to honor him come this weekend. And then on the other end, you have Lenny, you know, a civil rights pioneer, the first African-American football player in UD history. You know, for him, you know, he is a native of Wilmington, so right here around the corner, you know, another standout two-way player. Not sure how he was playing lineman for both sides of the ball. You, a former lineman, can attest that that is a lot.
That
right?
is a lot. That's a lot of energy. That's a lot of effort. It's awesome to hear about the great Blue Hens that came before me, and especially back then when they played both ways. You know, I played both ways in high school. It's a different game, obviously, in high school than it is in college at that level. But to play both sides of the ball, you don't get that rest. You don't get the time on the sideline to regroup and to try to figure out what you can do better in the next drive. You're just out there the whole time playing, and it's, you know, I remember back in the high school days, that's a lot of effort. That it's hard to play a full game. So I'm just so impressed when I hear about the Blue Hens, of the great Blue Hens past that played both ways.
A lot. And he was a starter. So, you know, it wasn't like it was a little bit of minutes. He was a starter, a three-year varsity player, another person in the 50s that led UD to such successful records, you know, having a 23-4 mark for UD while he was here, you know, and including, because, you know, Gino did want me to point out the Refrigerator Bowl victory back in 1954. You know, so definitely happy to have two former UD football players being honored this Friday in the UD Athletics Hall of Fame. You know, and another runner we have coming up is just another great player in Nijuel Hill, senior defensive back, who will be joining Gino and I up next on Under the Lights. We're back, and Gino and I are joined by senior defensive back Nijuel Hill. Nijuel, how are you doing today?
I'm doing good today. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good.
Nijuel, thanks for joining us today. So we're 4-4 right now, with three big conference games to finish out the season. What's the mentality of the team right now as you guys look to finish out strong?
Well, you know, we're just in control of our destiny right now. Coach Rocco said that we had to get to 4-4. And knowing our league, you know, everything's wide open right now. So, you know, we're just trying to lean in more together, you know, being all in. Just taking everything a lot more serious because, you know, our future is ahead of us, honestly. You know, if we do what we're supposed to do, our season can still go the way we want it to go.
Yep, one game at a time.
Speaking of one game at a time, Nijuel, you are a force to be reckoned with on the defense. Can you talk about the defense and your camaraderie and how that plays out for you guys on the field together?
Well, you know, our defense is really just like a brotherhood, honestly. You know, we always want the game to be on us, no matter how it goes, whether or not we're blowing the team out or it's down to the last seconds of the game. We always want the game to be in our hands. Coach Rojas always tells us that, you know, we want the game on us. We're a group of uncommon men, and because we're uncommon, we want the game to be always be on us, and that we want to honestly just try to shut everybody down, no matter who comes into our home.
Nice.
I love that. Nijuel, you've gotten your hands on the ball quite a bit throughout your career here, several picks and fumble recoveries. How good does it feel as a defender to get your hands on the football?
Well, honestly, it's the best feeling in the world, just because, you know, I don't get a lot of targets at cornerback, to be honest, you know, so you got to make the most out of your opportunities. You know, when you're on offense, you know when the play is coming to you, so you know when you're supposed to get the ball, but when on defense, especially at corner, you never know when you're going to get a target. You never know whether or not it's going to be a trick play or if the running back or the receiver fumbles the ball. So it's just the best feeling in the world. That's why you always want to see me, you know, jumping around, hyping around, being around my teammates, just having fun. Because, you know, I pray for those kind of those moments, honestly. So
that's what the game's all about.
The game all about.
You know, we see it now on your face. If you go out to practice, you know, the smiles are there, the passion is there. Where does your passion for football come from?
Well, honestly, my family. My dad played football at Bloomsburg University in PA. And a lot of my cousins back in Baltimore played. So I just wanted to got it from my family. I always saw my older cousins playing football. I used to go back in the alleys playing with them. And, you know, that's usually how it goes when you're playing with your family. You want to be like your big cousins. You want to be like your dad, you know. So when you come out here, that's always why I have a smile on my face, because I try to channel that inner kid, just knowing that I always want to have fun while I'm playing the game. So, nice.
Well, the question would be, is your dad going to say that you're a better football player, or is he a better football player? Watch it.
I mean, I would say that I am, you know, even though my dad was an All-American in Division II, I still think I can say that I was an All-American Division I AA, so I think he'll give me the A's.
That's great. So you're in your sixth year now here at Delaware. What's your favorite part about playing for the Blue Hens?
You know, just the energy that we bring every game. It doesn't matter if it's 20,000 people in the stands, or if it's, you know, 10,000 or 5,000. No matter how many people are out there, whoever is out there, we always bring that same kind of energy. I feel like, you know, we always going to create our own energy on the sideline, and, you know, just being a family, just being together. Honestly, throughout my years here, I've seen this program grow. We started off, you know, when I was here as my true freshman year, I think about 4-7 with Coach Brock. And then as Coach Rocco came, he's turned the whole program around, honestly, when it's just coming from the culture, just to being, having everybody to think about the team first instead of thinking about yourself. And he's always said that's the hardest thing that he's going to ask us to do. And I can truly honestly say that I think about the team first before I think even think about myself now. Just because, you know, when we're on the sideline, I try to pump up the offense. When they're down, you know, I tell them that we got their back. And the same when it comes with the offense. The offense tells us that they have our back, but we just probably let up a touchdown or something. So just that energy, always having each other's back, no matter how the game goes, that's probably the best part of being a Blue Hen.
Yeah, love that. I love that answer, Nigel. Thank you. Thanks for joining us. Come out and support the Blue Hens this Saturday, November 6th, 1 p.m. against conference rival William & Mary right here at Delaware Stadium.
And thanks for joining us on another episode of Under the Lights. Thank you, Nigel. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. And don't forget to follow Delaware Football on Twitter at DelawareFB and on Instagram at Delaware Football. And don't forget, for all things Blue Hen Athletics, visit www.bluehens.com. Until next time.